Heather. We just finished up our programming committee meeting, and boy, do we have a lot coming up. So I know this weekend we have an event. Why don't you tell me about that?
Okay. This weekend we are celebrating Bedlam here in Oklahoma. Mm-hmm. And we actually put out a Facebook poll, and that is what our guests wanted to do this weekend for Fifth Saturday, is celebrate Bedlam. We have crafts around the museum. You can make a necklace depending on which team is your favorite. We have color pages around the museum. We are going to have our turtles uniformed, sort of, and playing football throughout the day. Mm-hmm. Maybe by the end we'll have a winner, or maybe they'll just play back and forth all day and tie it up. We have got some paintings upstairs you can do, and you can focus on one side or the other, or the fact that we are part of both here in Oklahoma.
Right. So that's just free with general admission?
Yes, free with general admission.
Well, nice. I know December is a packed month. We have three events. I know the first event is Pancake and Pajamas on December 7th. Why don't you tell me a little bit about that one?
Okay. Pancakes and Pajamas is, I believe it's our second annual Pancakes and Pajamas. It's a newer event to us. We had so much fun last year, we wanted to do it again. From 8 to 10 in the morning, before the museum opens, we'll be having pancakes. Everyone can wear their PJs. Even some of our animals will be wearing their PJs. We have a couple of great Christmas crafts. We're going to have some stuff around the museum, of course, as well. We are going to have the most important thing that we are going to have is we have some special visitors. Mm-hmm. Santa will be coming to see us. Mrs. Claus will be coming. We are going to have one of the elves visit with them. But this year we also have a special guest. The Grinch is going to be joining
us. That's exciting.
As well.
And Mrs. Claus is going to be reading stories to the children, right?
Yes, she's going to stay and visit with the children for a little while that morning and read them some stories. There is a cost for that event because it is a meal. It is $5 if you're a member, and mm-hmm. it's $9 if you're not a member, which is our regular price for the museum. And if you come in and pay and eat your pancakes and PJs, you get to stay and play the rest of the day as well.
Oh, perfect. So there are giveaways, right?
Yeah, I think they have some giveaway prizes they're going to be doing as well.
That's exciting. So the second event in December is Nightmare Before Christmas. With a Friday the 13th in December, we thought a Nightmare Before Christmas.
Yes. So it tends to be a favorite seasonal movie, mm-hmm. And we wanted to get everyone together to watch it together. We are going to, it's not a very long event because it's in the evening, it's just a few hours. Mm-hmm. So you can come at 5:00, you get to play in the museum for a while. We have some special crafts you can make. We have some apothecary jars. We have a special painting that goes with the movie you can make in the art studio. Mm-hmm. And then everyone will move over next door to watch the movie.
Perfect. And there's snacks?
Yes, we are going to have some, not popcorn, but mm-hmm. something close to it called
similar.
Puffcorn.
Yeah.
That's a little safer for the small children.
So. And we do have a couple giveaways. I know that. You do have to be present to win.
Yes.
But the event is also bring your own blanket.
Yes, so. Bring your own blanket. We're all going to spread out on the floor. I happened to get a peek at some of those prizes, and they are very cool.
They are nice. So our last event coming up is a fan favorite, and that is New Year's Eve.
Yes. So New Year's Eve is when the kids get to celebrate the new year. Mm-hmm. We're going to have some great crafts that for celebrating. We're going to make some poppers. We all move over into the same area together to count down to noon and ring mm-hmm. in the new year half a day early.
Right.
So the kids can celebrate. They have a dance party. They get to pop their crafts that they've made. And we have a really, really neat balloon drop that we do every year. The balloons just come down and surround the kids, and their dance party is just a wonderful moment.
And I think I heard, I'm new, but I think I heard it's the largest balloon drop in Enid.
Probably, I would guess so. I don't know that for a fact, but I would guess so. I know there are a few thousand balloons in there.
That is exciting. Well, we do have a lot coming up, and it's going to be so much fun, and I really hope that everybody in Enid takes advantage of it because it's going to be a blast.
Yes, it's going to be wonderful. Thank you.
Yes.